Hello, I'm Ross. I'm a forensic psychology graduate student and I'm from Cameroon. Nice to meet you. I looked for schools around and it was either Missouri State or some weird school in Branson, so Missouri State was. And so far, I mean, I love it, I like it. I mean, I came here for like 3 years and graduated, and then for some reason decided to come back again, so there must be something here, right? So in general, I like going out and meeting new people, just because when I learned that the way our brain works is that they are schemers, which are like shortcut patterns because we're cognitive misers, and I realized that because of those schemers is how things like prejudice occur, because we don't really, it's just the way our brain is wired. If we don't know someone, we don't understand someone, we don't know a lot of things about someone, we're basically make assumptions on those people. So, and I want to understand people that are different than me. I believe that if you want to solve things like, say for example, like racism or discrimination or prejudice, all those things that you study in sociology, if you want to make for a better work environment, if you're let that's if you're becoming a HR manager, you need to understand people, you need to understand their cultures, their backgrounds, because when you get to understand that, then you get to put prejudice aside. And also, when you get to understand people, you realize that they're actually more similar to you than you would imagine. So someone might look different, but when you actually talk to them, the only difference is that you guys were maybe born in two different countries, or you just have two different backgrounds, but apart from that, you're quite similar. And that's one of the beauties I love in general with people, like talk with people. And that's also another thing I love in sociology, because sociology gives me the knowledge of it. Psychology is the same thing. And I would like in the future, you know, to help people in general. So I figured I might as well understand them for helping them. When I used to go to my dance studio, like Motion Playlist, which is downtown, in case you guys ever want to check it out. When I go there, all the people there, they don't usually look like me. I mean, some are Asian, some are black, some are white. But when you go on, when you step into a dance floor, all these things don't matter. You connect. You connect to people. So that's what dancing is to me. It helps me connect to people. People I don't think I would have known them otherwise. In a way, it's like, if you see me dance because I'm happy and I'm full of energy, that just simply means at that moment, that's me. That's like my personality is like amplified when I'm dancing, kind of. Yeah, so what I want students to take away from my story is that learn to respect people as much as yourself, because you never know where you would end up in life, and usually, and when you respect people, people tend to help you. And just because it's a decent thing to do. Also, there is no such thing as self-made, so you may think because you do a lot of things by yourself, you're self-made, but it's not self-made. Someone somewhere had to take a shot on you, someone had to approve your visa, someone had to look at your resume and say yes, someone had to look at your graduate CV and say yes. So always remember that, and that's it. And then always remember, at the end of the day, do you, because nobody got you like you. So so yeah, I can give you the world's advice, and if you choose to do your own thing, I mean, that's the way to go. Just, if you feel something and you're motivated, passionate about it, go for it. That's what I always say. Stay true to yourself.